Hey guys, it's Krystal, and iOS 11 was just announced today, and I have it right on here, so let's discover all the new things together. And there's actually a lot of things that they didn't even talk about, so I'm gonna show you guys. So here it is, iOS 11 right in front of my face. Before we begin, I just wanna say, this weird black and white, black home button iPhone that I have is just a cool DIY that I have going on. First thing I notice is when you power on the home screen, there's a new animation. It like kind of just, it kind of slowly like fades from the bottom to the top. And there's actually a lot of new animations that make the phone feel different. Like when you actually unlock the phone, lock screen just whoop, slides up into the top. Now before we get into the big new features here, there's a couple little things that I can already see is different. Like the dock on the bottom, there's no more labels under the apps. You can see it looks a little cleaner and nice. I definitely like it more. And on the top left where you see your cell reception, they went back to bars instead of the circles that they had, which makes a lot of sense because usually you refer to that as bars instead of circles. Now let's slide up that control center and wow, look at that difference. It's so much nicer looking now. First of all, I mean, there's a lot of things to talk about here. But first of all, you don't have to swipe through a bunch of different pages. I always thought that was so stupid because I would accidentally like change the brightness or change the volume. Everything's just all on one page the way it should be. I love the way the brightness slider and the volume slider looks now. You can 3D press on everything for more options. 3D press on here, got more options. 3D press on this stuff. Another cool thing they didn't tell you about is you can actually customize your control center when you go into settings. And go into control center, and whoa, you can just add and take away anything. So let's say I wanna add an alarm, maybe a stopwatch, because I use that for working out, so make it more accessible. Ooh, what's this? Screen recording, oh man. So you can record your screen, I guess? I'm recording the screen. You used to have to plug it into your MacBook to record your screen, but now you can just do it on your phone, which is amazing. Another thing that's been redesigned is notification shade, which at first when you pull down, it looks like you're just pulling down the lock screen and you're thinking like, what the heck is going on here? Now, I'm still trying to figure this out myself. I really don't completely understand what's going on here, but when your phone is unlocked and you receive notifications, you pull down that notification shade and they're all there. But the moment that you lock your phone and unlock it, the only way to see them is to swipe up on this thing that you see here, it says earlier today. I guess it's a way to stay more organized, but it does seem like extra work. It's kind of weird that they got rid of the notification panel completely, it seems like. You just go straight to your lock screen, but I guess it could be helpful. Now, probably my favorite improvement with iOS 11 is with the camera, specifically portrait mode. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you guys know I love me some portrait mode. And there's three big new things here. First of all, it's actually good in low light. It's usable. You can even use a flash if you want. And probably my favorite thing is an HDR mode on here. So you can finally see those skies exposed really well. Live photos also has a bunch of improvements. And I like live photos. I use it every once in a while. But what drives me crazy is when one of the frames from the live photo is better than the actual picture itself. Well, now you can choose the frame from the live photo to be the main picture. There's also some other cool effects that you can do with live photos now. Like you can loop them, you can bounce them, which is kind of like that boomerang thing from Instagram. And my favorite, long exposure. Now, it's not really a long exposure. It's just using all those frames from the live photo and making a nice smooth picture. Now let's go into messages because there's some new things there. Oh, look at that. There's a new animation when you're going in and out of apps now. There's just so many little things that really make it feel like a totally new phone. Now with iMessage, it is much easier to do all the cool things that you can do there, like the digital touch messages and stickers and GIFs, all that stuff. I love doing it, but it was so hard to do on here. But here on iOS 11, it's very easy because it has its own little dock on the bottom. One thing that I can't really show you guys on here, but they did talk about, is person-to-person Apple Pay embedded into iMessage. So it'll make it super easy to send money to your friends or whoever you owe money to. So let's say I owe Douglas here some $20. I could just send it to him through iMessage, which is amazing. There's a couple new things with my girl Siri here. So she understands context a lot better now, and she can translate languages too. Let's say you really have to go to the potty bath. Let's say you really have to use a potty and you're in Mexico, ole ole. How do you say that, Siri?
¿Dónde está el cuarto de baño?
You could just say el baño, but whatever. Apple Maps got a huge upgrade, and who actually uses Apple Maps, honestly? I feel like we all use Google Maps, right? For one big reason, lane guidance, but it's now coming to Apple Maps, so we can all use Apple Maps now. And the App Store looks completely different, completely redesigned. Again, it's looking like Apple Music, which looks beautiful in my opinion. Just the text looks nicer and cleaner. Everything looks more modern looking. Now, there's a lot of new things that Apple announced today besides iOS 11, like the new iMac Pro, some new MacBooks and iPads, and something completely new called HomePod, which my buddy Jonathan Morrison recapped in his full recap video, so make sure you go check that out if you want the full scoop of things. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you later.